أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته My dear brothers and sisters, I hope you're doing all amazingly well inshallah ta'ala. It's been a while since I joined you here on Revert to Islam, but I'm really glad to be back, alhamdulillah. And my name is Ustada Amina Blake, if you don't know me already. I'm very honoured to be with you, alhamdulillah. And today I'm going to be talking about something. It's going to be a short lecture, so because I know a lot of you are having like your dinner and stuff right now. So it's going to be a short lecture, and inshallah ta'ala, we are going to be talking about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala presents the method of da'wah in the Quran. And so we're going to start off with the basics, because of course when you climb a mountain you have to be able to walk first instead of climbing the mountain first, because it doesn't work like that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aims the Quran and the da'wah at who? And everybody, every believer. It's incumbent on us all to do da'wah. And brothers and sisters, you don't have to be a sheikh or a sheikha or anything like that to do da'wah. So some people think, oh, I can't do da'wah because I don't have the knowledge, or I don't have the hikmah behind it. Wallah, brothers and sisters, doing da'wah is not a difficult thing, and it can be done on many, many different levels. And that's what we're going to be exploring today. It's not just something that's reserved for people who are shuyukh and ustadhas and things like that. So let's bring it down to that level. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a default message to the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran in Surah 33 verse 46. And he says, and the one who invites to Allah, wada'iyan lillahi, wada'iyan lillahi. So that is the one who invites to Allah, bi'ithnihi, with his permission. So what does this mean here? This means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selects his workers, the people who give the da'wah, by what? With honour, and with what else? With his permission. How amazing is that? But da'wah comes with, but it comes with a massive responsibility on the people who are giving the da'wah. So there are two types of da'wah. There's one which is a positive da'wah, and there's one that I call an anti-da'wah. So it's when sometimes people will go with the intention of giving da'wah, but actually what happens is we do the opposite of da'wah. And why is this? Because we do da'wah with ilm, with knowledge, but without hikmah, without wisdom. And then unfortunately, sometimes we can damage. Or maybe we are doing da'wah at the wrong level for the people that we are speaking to. So this again is something to think about. If you are giving da'wah to a sheikh, and yes, believe me, the sheikh need the da'wah too. All of us need da'wah. And you're giving da'wah to somebody who is maybe a brand new Muslim who doesn't even know how to say La ilaha illallah properly, then this is different types of da'wah, right? They're going to be different methods of giving the da'wah to these people. So let's have a look at what happens. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the da'i, or the person who gives da'wah, with sirajan munira. It's a very beautiful metaphor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives in the Quran. The metaphor used, and there are two different types of light that we can mention here, both mentioned in the Quran. One of them is the nur, and the nur is the very delicate, and it's the reflected light. So for example, the light of the qamar, the moon, is told to us that it's a nur. But the light that is stronger, and this is the one that's being used here by Allah, siraj is a light, type of light that consumes itself. So it's a very strong and burning light, like the sun, for example, the shams. This is a siraj, whereas the moon, it's a qamar, like a munira, it's a gentle type of reflected light. So the person who is doing da'wah is described as the siraj, like the strong type of light. And why is this? Because it's active. The munira, or the nur, is a reflected light. It's not active. But when we're in da'wah, we have to be active. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described it as a siraj, the active light, subhanAllah. So the dirty or the dirtier must be like this light. And this was how the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. When he was giving his da'wah, he was giving it in an active way. And we have to give it in an active way, but also in a way that is appropriate for the circumstances. This session, we're not going to be talking about that. However, we are going to talk about the example of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, we are told in the Quran, Surah 33, verse 21, in the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have a good example to follow. And Aisha radiallahu anha said to us that the character of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a reflection of the Quran. And many beautiful things were said about the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the way he gave his da'wah, which was the most beautiful of da'wah. Did you ever hear about the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam being harsh or nasty or evil to anybody? He was never, subhanallah. And he was always appropriate to the people that he was speaking to. And so let's see that da'wah is like a tree. What happens with a tree? A tree must have strong roots before it starts to grow. If a tree has strong roots, then what happens? The tree will grow strongly, so the stem and the branches, and eventually what? The leaves and the flowers. And what comes from the flowers? Comes the fruit. And all of this is a process, it's a natural process. So what is the stage, the first stage of the process of da'wah, the roots of da'wah? Let me share something really important with you. It's a story from the Quran. We know the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam was accused by the wife of Al-Aziz. And he was accused of what? He was accused of like trying to attack her and to having some affair with her, subhanAllah. And why did Al-Aziz quickly believe the story of Yusuf alayhi salam? Why did he believe him rather than believing his wife? There were two reasons. Two reasons that we're thinking about. Number one, his shirt was torn from the back, not from the front, which shows what? That he was going away from her, not towards her. And number two, when Yusuf alayhi salam came into this community, he came as a stranger, but he built up something very, very essential, which made them believe his story, and that was trust. How is it that we can go to someone who doesn't have trust in our community, who doesn't have trust in Muslims, or trust in Islam, or trust in the Quran, and we are, subhanAllah, the ambassadors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the people who are living Islam, the Muslims. So how can we go to someone and speak to them about Islam and expect them to accept this without having this foundation of trust first? If you look at the stories of the Prophet, including the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Musa alaihi salam, Yusuf alaihi salam, they all had this main foundation, and this is why this is the root of da'wah, is building a trusting and beautiful relationship with people. Before you even say a word or breathe a word about Islam, you do what first? You build this foundation of trust. Okay, so I can hear you thinking, okay, how am I going to build this foundation of trust? Well, how? By being the best person that you possibly can, by following the sunnah of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in your actions. So what is this? This is being trustworthy always, being honest always, being kind always. And when somebody is bad towards you, we do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, and also what was the practice of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by covering the evil that somebody does to you with something better than it, something good. Because we know, even in science, you have a negative force, you put a positive on top of it, then what comes out of it? It comes out a positive, subhanAllah. So this is the first lesson of da'wah. Be building this relationship of trust, because then when you do eventually give the message of Islam, and believe me, if somebody trusts you, they're going to come to you and they're going to start asking you. They'll start asking you, sister, why did you put this hijab? Sister, you're white, how come you're Muslim? It's weird. They start asking you these questions, but they're not going to feel confident to ask you about things unless you have built the trust up first. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all in this message of his da'wah and help us all to follow the sunnah and the beautiful path of our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So for now, I love you all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My du'as are going out to you. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.